Hello and welcome to Excel for Freelancers. Today we're going to be showing you how to highlight a selected row in a table, which is a really great way to see what row you're on. Okay, let's get started. To highlight that selected row, what we want to do first is enable a specific cell to record that row. So what we're going to do is we're just going to write down selected row here, and then we're going to use A4. So let's just start out, let's put 9 here, and that'll just be our initial value. Okay, so this particular cell is going to be the one in which we record the row. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to use conditional formatting. Okay, so what we want to do is we want to highlight the entire table here, okay, and go into conditional formatting. And then we're going to select a new rule. Okay, so once we have the new rule, this pop-up comes up, and we'll want to use a formula. Okay, so we're going to click on use a formula, and then we're going to enter the formula. It's a very simple formula, and all we're going to do is we're going to write an equals, and then we're going to select the cell in which we're using to record the row. So in this case, it's A4. Okay, so A4, and then we're going to equals, and then row, and then open and close parentheses like that. Okay, and now we're going to set the format. What is the format that we want for this particular row? So we're going to click format, and then we're going to click fill. Okay, fill. Okay, and what do we want? We want to fill this row with some different colors. So we're going to click on fill effects here, and in this case I'm going to use a dark blue theme. So we'll click, we're going to click two colors, and then we're going to click, we're going to use a fade out from a dark blue to just a little bit lighter. So we'll click here. And then I also want to change the font color of that selected row. So I'm going to click font. Okay, we're going to make it bold, and then we're going to select a color, and we're going to select white, which is this upper left-hand corner. Okay, so we're going to select a white font on a dark background. Okay, and you can't see it here, but it's a white font on the preview. And then we're going to click OK. And so basically, here's the preview of what that selected row is going to look like. Okay, and when we click OK, and we'll take a look and see now it's selected row. And if we go back into the conditional formatting, we can see the rule that we just created. Okay, so we'll go in condition, we're going to manage rules, and here we see the conditional formatting we just created, and this applies to the entire range. Because we selected that range, it's automatically set. We could also reselect a range by choosing a different range, okay? Just simply by selecting the range, okay? But we'll keep it from E5 to K14, and that is the range of the table. We can set this range. You can set it. You can set the rows to go all the way down to whatever you want, and we'll just apply that and then click OK. So basically, the idea is when this row changes, the highlighting. So if we were to put change 8, you'd see the change. If we were to change 6, okay, it changes. So the idea is whatever row is here is going to be highlighted. And now what the idea is, what we want to do is when we select a row, we want this number to change. Okay, so to do that, we're going to use VBA. And if you've never used VBA before, don't worry about it. It's going to be very simple, and I'm going to walk you through it. There's two ways to get into the VBA screen. And one way is to Alt F11 is a shortcut, and that will get you to the VBA screen here. The other way is if you showing a developer tab to click Visual Basic, like that. And if you do not have a developer tab, which most of you don't, you simply go into Properties, Options here, Options, and then click on the customized ribbon, and then just select the developer tab right here. So by selecting that, it will show up here. Okay, and so once we do that, once we launch the Visual Basic, what we want to do then is basically create some code when we select a particular cell. And so what we're going to do is we're going to click. First, we're going to make sure that we're on the right sheet, and we're currently working in sheet 1, so we want to stay in sheet 1. Okay, whatever sheet you're working in, just double click that to make sure you're on the right sheet. And what we want to do is we want to click worksheet here from the options here, worksheet. And then the idea is what action do you want to run this code? And our idea is going to be selection change. So you want to look for selection change, which should already be, because basically we want some code to run when we select a cell, okay? And so we're going to keep it a selection change. And that means you have to write some code in between this private sub worksheet selection change and the end sub. So we're going to write code between that. And basically the code we're going to write is basically it says when we select a cell within the range of this table, we want whatever row we're selecting, we want the row to appear here, okay? So that is the idea. So we're going to write some code, right? And it basically is this: if not intersect, and then parentheses target. And you don't have to remember this. I'll make sure there's a download available so you can copy and paste it. So please don't worry about it. And then what we want is we want to select the range. And what is the range? The range is basically E5 through K14, okay? E5 through K14, okay? And that's the range. And then close the parentheses twice since we've opened it. Okay, is nothing, then, and what do we want to do? Okay, and you notice the end if popped up automatically. It will not on yours because I've got some special. So just make sure you write end if, right? And then everything in between is here. And so basically, what do we want to happen? Well, we want the row to write, but just so we're making sure, let's just put some code in here, message box test, just so we know that it's working right, okay? So when we go back, now when we go back and we select test, pop-up comes up, great. Okay, when we select outside, nothing happens. When we select inside, test comes up. Okay, so we know that code is working great, but we don't want a message box test, but we want this row to change, A4 to change. So we're gonna select range, okay, A4.value equals target.row. Okay, so basically the target, the row, this will put the actual row of whatever we want inside this cell here. So let's go ahead and test that out now. You see how the row changes? And because the row is changing, and because we have conditional formatting set up, it changes automatically. It's very simple, okay? And I'll make sure to include a link to this workbook so that you can copy and paste this code. You don't need to remember it. Okay, and now one other option is, and you'll see here, we're selecting every row, but what if we only want to select rows with actual values? And if it's blank, we don't want to select. Well, that's an easy option too. And I'll walk you through that. All we have to do is make a slight change within the conditional formatting. And I'll walk you through that here. So we pull up our managing rules and we pull up that conditional formatting and we edit that rule. And basically what we want to do is we want to say to Excel, hey, only if there's values in a specific column do we want the highlighting to show up. So we just have to start here and we put an and, okay? Because there's going to be more than one option now. And what we do is we'll select the first, because most tables will have your customer name, whichever field you feel is required or which we'll put in there. So in this case, we're going to use customer name, E5. Okay, but we want to use this for every row in the table, not just row 5. So we don't want that fixed. We're going to take the dollar sign before 5 out. Okay, so if E5 does not equal nothing, then we want to run the code. So that's all we have to do, and we want to close those parentheses. Okay, so basically there's a condition that we've added, so we want to make sure that E, the column, is fixed, everything in E, and every row within that table does not equal nothing, then we want it to run, then it'll change. Okay, so we click okay, and the range stays the same. So now we'll just apply that and click okay. Now when we select nothing, now when we select a row with nothing in column E, no highlighting is done, except only rows where there's a value in column E. And that's pretty much it. That's how you select it. And oftentimes you don't want your, you know, you may not want to see this, so you can just hide the column, okay? So keep it simple, we can hide that. That way people don't see it if you don't want it to be, you know, so usually put it in a column and then I hide that column. And that's how you select the, highlight the selected row. It's quite simple. Please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and select the Send Me All Notifications options so that you can get our videos to you right away as soon as we create them.